So what's cool about the vault is that we also can create some notes, some secure notes. And if I come down here and select to add, I can add a folder or I can add an item. Let's add an item real quick. I can give it a name and type in notes. Maybe this is my code for the house lock, door lock. And let's see, we can put it in a separate folder. The only folder that's in there right now is shopping, but I can create my own folder on the fly. I can maybe put home stuff. And I can say the code is 1234. And I can hit save. And there's my note for me. And you'll notice here it's under my notes section. I can also save addresses. I can also put in credit card information. This makes it really nice so that when I'm buying something online, it'll autofill it out for me. So I don't have to remember my numbers. I still typically get asked for my 3-digit code on the back of the card. I can create bank account or add bank account information here. Again, the options are kind of endless. Some of the things I use my notes for is I have information. Matter of fact, if we go back in to this particular note, you'll notice that I can do an attachment. I've actually gone through and I have my driver's license and I have a photo of my driver's license. I also have my driver's license number listed on that. Again, just important documents you can put in here. There's also the security challenge, which we'll get into another video, as well as the sharing center. I can share my passwords with my kids if they need access to, I don't know, to Hulu, but I don't have to tell them what the password is. If they have LastPass, I can just say, hey, you can use my password, and they just see asterisks. It's really kind of cool. And of course, we have some account settings. We also have some additional options, including obviously they want you to go to premium. I actually recommend doing the LastPass for families. What this allows you to do is to basically have 6 accounts, yours plus 5 additional family members or friends, whoever you want, I guess, to have access to this particular product. It's a great deal. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and hit back here, and we're going to take us back here to our vault. Okay, I'm going to give you a treat here. I'm going to actually bring up my own personal LastPass. So hang on a second. Okay, so I've logged back in, and I'm using my own personal LastPass. You can see it right here. So here I am in my vault, and you can see that I've got quite a bit. I've categorized a lot of them already. I still got a lot of work to do because I got a bunch that's still under none. And you can kind of see here quickly that, there's a lot of them. Okay, so let's do this. I want to actually change my Instagram password. So I'm going to just type in INS, and of course, it narrows things down here for me. I'm going to select to launch the Instagram page. Okay, so here I am on my own personal Instagram. I'm just going to come up to my little person guy, and I'm going to select to edit my profile. Under my edit profile, I'm going to select to change the password. It says, okay, what password? What was your old password? You'll notice the 2 option because I have 2 accounts. And I'm going to just select my personal account and hit fill. It filled in my old password. It now says, okay, what do you want to do for your new password? See the little recycle button? I'm going to click on that. And look, it's prompted me to change the password. It created a password for me. Again, I can select to show the options so I can change or adjust the size. Again, I like anything above 16. So we'll just leave this one for 19. I'm going to make sure I'm using all my characters. And I'm going to now blur out my password so you can't see which one I'm going to use. I'm just going to randomly cycle through. I really don't care which one. I'm just going to select now to fill the password. And again, it's filled it. Notice what's happened. It says, hey, do you want to update it for Dale Meredith? Yes, I'd like to update it. And I'm going to go ahead and hit select change the password. And that's it. This is why I don't worry or I don't care or I don't even know my passwords. The only password we have to know is that master password. Oh, looks like it asked it one more time. We'll go ahead and select to update it. So now when we come back to log back in, and so when I log back in, booyah, I'm back in with a new password. That's easy schmeasy. Hey, thanks for watching. I hope you learned something. Something to help make you and your family more secure. If you'll do us a favor and do what everybody else tells you to do to support the channel, you know, hit the subscribe notification button, that would really help. If you want to leave some comments, that's great too. In fact, if you want to see some particular products out there and want to know how to secure them for your family, let us know.